planting the seeds that drugs are wrong and that drugs are harmful may work in some cases, perhaps in many cases. But for people who live with the everyday reality of drugs and drug dealers, it's a totally different story. Gary Kauf has that part of our report.
Out here in the flatlands of East Oakland, the choice is very clear, every day. You can take the high life, sell the drugs, drive a fancy car, wear the heavy gold chains, or go slow, hang around the playground on your days off, with nothing but change in your pocket, and play basketball all day.
It really is tempting. Just to see somebody walk, you know, up and down the street, you see people riding around in fancy cars, you'd be like, hey, why can't I get that? You know, he got it, why can't I get that?
It's just like a cancer. Cancer spreads. Okay, just like drugs. Drugs spread.
It starts when they're little kids.
They see one of their little partners riding around a bicycle or something like that. They want them a bicycle too. But, you know, their mother ain't got no
That's
money
right.
for no bicycle. So then, you know, they're going to go get them some money somewhere. So then you have the start of a drug dealer.
At a time when the product is cheap and plentiful. A gram of coke that sold for $120 a few years ago can be had for as little as $50 now. Coke used to be called the rich man's drug, but by melting it and adding baking soda, it can be stretched and sold by the rock in a $5 or $10 bag. The people out here say to make any inroads against the users or the dealers, society must learn how to compete, to offer an attractive enough alternative. Because right now, the rising white tide of crack is all-powerful.
Why would a person making $500 in one day go to work at McDonald's and have somebody on his back when he don't have to listen to that stuff? He gonna make more money coming out here in one day than he is in 2 weeks there.
So what would they do if they were in charge?
Put more of my resources toward younger kids and toward educationalizing our younger kids in drugs and also in sports, more activities, more playgrounds, more recreational sports.
More job opportunities in the neighborhood, you know, raise the minimum wage.
To do it with the parents, because the parents got to have that control. If the parents don't have the control, the kids going to run. I think it starts from home.
One more thing that a lot of people brought up is that you've got to start at the top and get the big guys, the ones who are bringing the drugs in. Just say no is fine, but what you've really got to do is cut off the supply. In Oakland, Gary Kauf for the 10 o'clock news.
The crack epidemic isn't limited to the Bay Area. In Denver, the situation has gotten so out of hand that police have adopted an unusual tactic. They locate an area of known street sales, then they warn the dealers to get out of that area for a while. Then undercover officers take over the corners, pretending to be dealers. Drivers who stop to buy crack are sold a harmless substance that looks like cocaine, then the unsuspecting suspects are arrested. Police officials say the reverse sting has long-term benefits since it confuses potential buyers, leaving them suspicious of anyone posing as a street dealer. A South Bay woman